Tutsi about this.
Comb.
Come in.
Herr Knight. There are some people here to see you.
Me?
Yeah, if you please come.
What's going on? You've been acting strange all day.
Please, just come. And don't forget your talisman. You must wear it always.
Damn thing's heavy. Well, hello there. Shouldn't those be torches?
Pardon, Herr Knight. I am Werner Huber. Forgive our coming here so late, but we must speak with you.
What can I do for you? Oh,
this is my cousin, the Huber Sepp. He has a farm just outside of Munich. I will tell you the truth, Herr Knight. We have come for the Schattenjäger.
I see. What makes you think you need a Schattenjäger?
It is because of Sepp here. Two nights ago, his wife goes to the window of the house to call in their daughter, Tony. It is getting dark. The light outside is not so good, yeah? She sees Tony some meters away, playing in the grass. And she sees a wolf. It is huge. And it is moving towards the child. Walter screams to the child, warning.
Five!
And that is when the beast strikes.
Tony!
Oh, no, langsam, langsam. They say she died quickly. Sepp here hears his wife screaming, comes running from the barn. He sees the wolf, goes inside the house to get a gun. But when he comes out, no wolf. And it has taken part of the child with it.
That's horrible.
Yeah. Yeah, it is very bad, Herr Knight. That is why we come to you.
Haven't the police been notified?
Oh, yeah, natürlich. The police, they think it is wolves escaped from a zoo. They search and search, but they find nothing. This is not the first such killing. And if it is not stopped, it will not be the last.
I'm not really sure what you want me to do.
The killer is not wolf. It is werewolf. You must hunt it down and kill it.
Werewolf? What makes you think it's a werewolf?
The wolf looked at me. Its eyes were human. It knew what it was doing. It knew.
I'm really very sorry about your daughter, Herr Huber.
I have told them that you are the new Schattenjäger.
You wear the talisman. Are you the Schattenjäger now? Or are you not?
I am.
We do not know you, Herr Knight. But we have known the Schattenjägers for many centuries. It is to them we turn in trouble like this. Sepp here is family. Will you come? Just look around, see what you can see. Huh? Sepp and his wife go north to be with her mother. You can stay on his farm.
All right. I'll look into it for you. See what I can see.
I'll pack your things.
Great, thanks. I'll meet you in the village in an hour.
Oh, thank you, Herr Knight. Thank you.
That's me, Gabriel Knight. I don't think the Ubers want me in their private bedrooms. I take it the Ubers are Catholic. China, our homie. Family talisman. Wolfgang gave up his life to get this back. A Schattenjäger knife. My wallet. It actually has money in it these days.
My new tape recorder, a dual mount.
My notebook.
Brilliant prose, if I do say so myself. Unfortunately, I'm just pissing the wind until I can think of a plot line. Maybe this case will inspire me.
A little too tasteful, if you ask me. Gracie ordered them. It's from the Ritter family lawyers.
Gabriel, I've just notified the Catholic Church about a miracle. Things have actually been picking up around the shop. We've been going through stock like a real store. I keep expecting the candid camera guys to pop out at any moment and say, just kidding. In other acts of universal randomness, the Voodoo Murders is up to number 20 on the New York Times bestseller list. Yes, the tastes of the American public can be a terrifying thing. In any case, your U.S. bank account is blossoming, not unlike the desert after a fluke storm. If you don't mind, I'd like to use a little of the money to fix up the shop. Your gran is fine, but misses you. Mosley has been hanging around, making himself a real pain in the butt. Fortunately, I need only bring up the bald detective Mosley in your book, all 240 pounds of him, and your pal turns red and is out the door in about 5 seconds. Things are organized here, just waiting for your decision. I think you can find a buyer if you want to go that route. I know you hate to write, but I need to get a feeling for what your plans are so I can make some of my own. I haven't seen or heard of anything here that seems relevant to this Schattenjäger business. Take care, Grace.
I don't need anything else right now. Who should I call? I don't need to call Gracie. I could call Ubergraub, but I'd rather just go over there. I can't read much of it, but they give the name of the zoo. It's in Thalkirchen. The name of the detective on the case is Lieber. From the police station near Prinsver Gentenplatz.
Better let Gracie know I'm on a new case.
There, Knight. The keys for the car are by the door. It is better not to drive inside Munich. Drive road 96 to Lockham. Park the car and take the U-Bahn from there. Thank you for helping us. Frau Huber. The Yubas have a nice setup here. A bit domesticated for my taste, but nice. I suppose that's for tending those window boxes. I could be wrong, but I think this bag contains cement. Now. Quick drying cement? Well, that's useful.
A metal pail.
Nothing of interest in there. It's a water trough. Ground's a bit muddy over here. Jesus, it's as big as my hand. That paw print is as big as my hand. These woods go back a ways. Plenty of space to hide. Something's been here. Maybe the thing that killed Yuba's daughter.
It'll take a minute to set.
Don't think I need any more cement. It's huge. I wish I knew if it were normal or not. Just looks like reddish hair to me. I'm gonna need help analyzing it. I was hoping for a Mercedes, but this'll have to do. Nice of the Ubers to loan me their car.
Ja, kann ich Ihnen behilflich sein?
Guten Tag. Do you speak English?
Nein, ich spreche kein Englisch. Was möchten Sie bitte?
Great. Lieber. Criminal Kommissar Lieber. Is he here?
Kommissar Lieber, wer möchte mit ihm sprechen? Denn Sie sind?
Sie, me! Oh!
Ja.
Oh, ja. Right. Writer. You know, books. That's me.
No, books.
Yeah.
Me.
Kommissar Leber, bitte. Kann hier kommen? Tut mir leid, Kommissar Leber ist zu beschäftigt. Hat absolut keine Zeit. Nein, kann Sie leider nicht sehen. Ist zu beschäftigt. Auf Wiedersehen. Auf Wiedersehen, mein Herr. Die Tür.
Right, thanks. Bitte.
Mehr kann.
Canis lupus lupus, European wolf.
Hey, wolf. Come on, boy. Hey, Wolfie, come on. Come on, Wolfie, Wolfie. Come on, come on. Get the heck over here, will ya? Here, Wolf. Come on, Wolf. Come on. Come on. It's like that, is it?
If I could get some wolf hair, I could compare it with the hair from the farm. I'm not sure what it says, but it's not the exit. Exit is Ozgang. It's one of the few words I do know. That must be the entrance to the wolf habitat.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes.
Great. Mind if I ask you some questions?
Yeah, okay.
Have you worked here long?
Tomas. Almost one whole year.
A year? Wow. I noticed you were pretty calm walking in that kennel. Guess wild animals don't bother you, huh?
The wolves. They are lazy during the day.
Oh. These wolves are fascinating, aren't they? I tried calling one over, but they weren't too obliging.
Yeah, some people try that all day.
Is there any chance you could take me inside the kennel? I'd really like to see one of the wolves up close, kind of a research thing.
No way. No one will enter the kennel without authorization.
So you carry a walkie-talkie?
The zoo is big.
Who normally gives you your instructions over that thing?
Kitchen, sometimes the health unit. For something really important, a Dr. Klingman himself will call me.
Dr. Klingman? Who's this Dr. Klingman you mentioned?
Herr Dr. Klingman is in charge of the mammal division.
So I should speak to him about seeing the wolves up close?
You can try, but he won't let you.
Perhaps. Where could I find him?
In the administration area.
Thanks. Hey, thank you for your time.
Whatever.
Come and see. Kann ich Ihnen helfen?
I'm afraid my German isn't very good. My name's Gabriel Knight. I'm an American novelist.
What can I do for you, Mr. Knight?
I'm researching a new book, and I hear you're the expert in these parts. Could you spare a moment?
Please, sit down.
Thank you.
Yeah, the doc's definitely got a thing for wolves. I don't see anything in the bookcase but German textbooks.
Looks like office equipment back there. Yeah, doctor's coat.
Could I ask you some questions?
Yes.
Thanks. You don't mind if I record this, do you?
That's fine.
So, you're in charge of the zoo's mammal divisions?
Yes.
What kind of training do you need for that, Doc?
I realize you Americans hate titles, but people refer to me as Herr Dr. Klingman here. Herr Doctor will also do.
Sorry.
I have a doctorate from Heidelberg University. My field is animal behaviorist.
Fascinating. I see you're particularly interested in wolves.
Yes, I'm quite well known for my wolf research.
You must have been horrified when two of your wolves escaped then.
Yes, it has been very unsettling.
Do you mind if we talk briefly about the missing wolves?
Is this relevant to your book?
Oh, yeah. You see, wolves are major characters in my new novel, and this case is quite unusual, isn't it?
I suppose it is. Very well. Actually, I know very little about the case, but I will tell you what I can.
Appreciate it. How long have the wolves been missing?
It's been about 2 months.
Jeez. Whew, that's a while, isn't it? It's strange the police haven't seen hide nor hair of them, so to speak.
Believe me, your sentiment is shared by the German public.
Do you think the zoo wolves are responsible for the mutilation killings?
That is yet to be proven.
Because I've been wondering, what else could it be? Wild wolves, maybe?
Unfortunately, there are very few wild wolves left in Germany. Most were killed off by hunters decades ago.
Most?
A few remain in the Alps. But so close to a city like Munich, it's highly unlikely.
Any other suggestions?
I'm afraid I'm as confused as anyone, Mr. Knight.
What I don't see is why wolves, if the killers are wolves, why wolves would attack humans.
Wolves are predators. Most carnivores are potential man-eaters, given hunger enough and opportunity.
But weren't the zoo wolves raised among humans?
Yes. And therefore, they are not afraid of us.
I suppose. How does a wolf choose its victims?
Have you ever heard of the language of death?
No.
You may have heard that wolves often choose the young, the old, or the sick as prey. Until recently, many thought this was some sort of natural selection going on, survival of the fittest. But now some of us are finding it is much more complicated than that. We have observed, for example, wolves surround a sick moose cow. The creature was helpless, yet she stood up and glared back at her would-be killers. The wolves dispersed. Or a healthy bull who ran off alone when he sensed wolves, making himself an easy target for no apparent reason. Researchers now believe that there's a kind of primal language going on. I am death, the wolf says. Are you ready to go? And the victim, by its actions, says, yes, I am ready, or no, you will not take me now.
What if their prey doesn't know the language of death?
This is a big problem, particularly for the wolves. When wolves come across domesticated animals who do not know how to play the game, they're confused. They start slaughtering and they have no sense for when to stop. That is why farmers have hunted wolves to extinction in most parts of the world.
Well, that certainly gives me something to think about. I'd rather ask someone who's not involved. This guy's a little too close to the fire not to be reflecting heat. Thank you for your time, Doctor.
Not at all.
Can I ask you something else?
Yes.
I suppose you were around when those wolves escaped.
No, I don't work at night.
But you must have been here the next day, right? The people were pretty upset, what with the police and everything?
Oh, yeah. Yes, that day was super crazy.
Can you tell me about it?
Tell you what?
So, how'd the wolves escape, anyway?
Well, Dr. Klingman says the gate was left open after the night feeding.
What do you think?
The gate is heavy, it shuts itself. Maybe something was in the way, maybe a rock, I don't know. I'm only glad it was not me there. The boy who works that night has been, you know.
Oh, fired.
Fired.
So, what do you think about these killings? Pretty scary, huh? Do you ever think those two wolves could do something like this?
I don't believe it is possible. Hilda and Parsifal were fine with me, just like all the other wolves. Hilda, she liked to play. She was so young still.
She did. What did the two missing wolves look like, anyway?
Hilda was pretty. She had much white on her chest. And Parsifal, he was bigger, sicker, more in the chest. He was 5 or 6 years old, maybe. Much darker than Hilda.
Dark? Dark what?
Dark gray. Both were gray. And most of the wolves here are. Hilda was light, but they get darker when they get older.
Is that right? Hey, thank you for your time.
Whatever.
I can't think of anything else to ask. Zoo administration.
Oh, Mr. Knight.
Yeah, Doctor? Sorry to bother you again.
Oh, not a problem.
A walkie-talkie. Didn't Thomas have one like that?
What kind of wolf research do you do, Herr Doctor?
I study wolf society here and in the wild.
Any insights?
Only that there is a purity to nature which human society lacks.
Meaning?
Life, reproduction, death. In nature, there's a purpose to it, even if that purpose isn't pretty. We humans have forgotten our purpose.
We have?
Yes. Does a male lion say to the female, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid to make a commitment? Does a female wolf run off and leave her offspring to the male because she wants to mate with another wolf? Do hyenas need psychotherapy because they are guilty about their thieving nature?
You have a point.
Which I'm afraid I have overstated.
Not at all. Do your fellow scientists share your views?
Not often, no. Fortunately, I have found others who do.
I was speaking with one of your boys out front, Greg, was it?
No, there's no Greg on staff here. Do you mean Thomas?
Thomas, right. Anyway, he's the one that said to talk to you. Because I was wondering if there was any way I could get a closer look at one of the wolves. For research?
I'm afraid this is not possible. We don't show our wolves to anyone. We must protect what privacy the creatures have.
Really? Well, gosh. Guess that's that.
Can't think of what else to ask him.
Thank you for your time, Doctor.
Ooh, not at all.
I have to load a tape first. If I'm gonna do a splice, I'll need a source tape in deck A. If I'm gonna do a splice, I'll need two tapes loaded. Not a bad idea. But I should go somewhere more private first. First things first, I need to address my audience. I think I'll need to voice some authority here. Now it's time to shoot for the grand prize. Okay, the only thing missing is the intended recipient of this fine hospitality.
Thomas, Herr Dr. Klingmann here. Show our words to Mr. Knight.
Gotta love it. Klingman's back there. I don't think there's anything else in there.
Thomas?
Ja, Thomas hier.
Herr Dr. Klingmann hier. Show our wolves to Mr. Knight?
Ja, okay, Herr Doktor.
Mr. Knight? I'm afraid I was just about to leave.
Oh, that's all right. Perhaps another day.
Perhaps. Good luck with your work, Mr. Knight. After you?
Oh, hello, Mr. Knight. I have orders to show you one of the wolves.
Really? That would be swell.
Please stay calm and go slow. They don't like strangers. This is a special treat I use to make them come to me. They love it. Marguerite, come here. Come all here, Mädchen. Marguerite, schau mal, was ich hier hab. Na, komm mal hier.
Hey, girl. Good girl.
Ach, how strange. She likes you.
I have a way with women.
She's wearing a tag.
All the wolves here wear them.
Don't do that! Stop that at once!
Sorry.
You should not have done that, Mr. Knight.
She seems so tame, just like a dog.
Wolf is not dog, Mr. Knight.
Sorry, really.
Yeah. Well, at least nothing happened. Are you done here now?
Yeah, thanks. I'll put in a good word for you with Klingman.
Oh, wunderbar.
Hair for Marguerite. It's gray. No way. I've had enough of those wolves, thanks. They don't look dangerous. It looks like a receipt. There's some carbon on the back, but I can't make out what it says. Klingman's office is locked. I already wrote one letter to Gracie. Don't want to give the poor girl a heart attack.
The Kona Glitch A Rich Half Jad Lodge, 54 Dino Strasse.
The Kona Glitch Bay Rich Half Jad Lodge, 54 Dina Strasse. No point in going back in there at the moment. I can't even try to talk my way in.